Halo rekan hebat, hari ini saya mau spill 30 pertanyaan dan juga jawaban berkaitan dengan triangulasi data atau triangulasi sumber pada saat kita melakukan sidang tertutup untuk mendapatkan gelar PhD, Doktor Ilmu Akuntansi. Karena ini untuk mendapatkan gelar PhD, maka saya akan spill 30 pertanyaan dan jawaban dengan bahasa Inggris. Let's check it out. Section number one, about data triangulation. Question number one, what is data triangulation and why is it important in qualitative research? Answer, data triangulation is a method of validating data by cross-checking it against multiple sources, and it is essential in qualitative research to ensure the accuracy and reliability of findings. Number two, what types of data triangulation did you use in your study? Answer, I use different types of data triangulation, including data source triangulation, methodological triangulation, and investigator triangulation. Number three, can you explain data source triangulation and how did you apply it in your study? Answer, data source triangulation involves using multiple sources of data, such as interviews, observations, and documents to validate findings. I apply it by collecting data from different sources, including taxpayers, tax authorities, and government officials. Number four, what is methodological triangulation and how did you apply it in your study? Answer, methodological triangulation involves using multiple research methods, such as interviews, observations, and surveys to collect data. I applied it by using semi-structured interviews, observation, and document analysis to collect data. Number five, can you explain investigator triangulation and how did you apply it in your study? Answer, investigator triangulation involves using multiple researchers to collect and analyze data to validate findings. I applied it by working with a team of researchers to collect and analyze data. Section 2, about data sources. Question number 6, what were the different data sources used in your study? Answer, the data sources used in my study included semi-structured interviews, observations, documents, and secondary data from reputable sources. Can you explain the semi-structured interview method used in your study? Answer, semi-structured interviews involve open-ended questions that allow respondents to provide detailed responses while also ensuring that the research objectives were met. Number 8. How did you select the respondents for the semi-structured interviews? Answers. Respondents were selected based on purposive sampling, ensuring that they had experience with tax reform policies and were knowledgeable about taxpayer compliance. Number 9. What types of documents were used in your study and how did you analyze them? Answer. Documents used in my study included tax laws, regulation, and policies, as well as reports from government agencies and non-governmental organizations. I analyzed them using content analysis and thematic analysis. Section 3. About data analysis. Question number 10. What data analysis techniques did you use in your study? Answer, I used thematic analysis, content analysis, and narrative analysis to identify